Despite the widespread prevalence of HIV, a small subset of the population appears to be naturally resistant to HIV infection. This phenomenon has intrigued scientists for decades, prompting extensive research to uncover the underlying mechanisms of this resistance. In this video, we will explain reasons why some individuals cannot contract HIV. 1. Genetic mutations, the CCR5 delta 32 allele. One of the well-documented genetic factors contributing to HIV resistance is the presence of a specific mutation in the CCR5 gene. The CCR5 gene encodes a protein that acts as a co-receptor for HIV to enter human cells. The mutation, known as CCR5 delta 32, involves a deletion of 32 base pairs in the gene, resulting in a truncated protein that cannot be expressed on the cell surface. Individuals who inherit two copies of the CCR5 delta 32 mutation, one from each parent, are almost completely resistant to HIV-1 infection because the virus cannot enter their cells through the CCR5 pathway. Those with one copy of the mutation have a reduced susceptibility to HIV and, if infected, tend to progress to AIDS more slowly than those without the mutation. This discovery has been pivotal in understanding HIV resistance and has spurred interest in developing treatments that mimic this natural genetic defense. We will be making more update on this, and you will be notified if you subscribe and hit the notification bell. While the CCR5 delta 32 mutation is the most well-known genetic factor, other genetic variations also play a role in HIV resistance. Polymorphisms in genes encoding other chemokine receptors, such as CXCR4, and in genes involved in the immune response, like HLA genes, have been linked to variations in susceptibility to HIV. For example, certain human leukocyte antigen system plays a crucial role in the body's adaptive immune response. Certain HLA types are more effective at presenting HIV antigens to the immune system, allowing for a more vigorous and effective attack on the virus. Individuals with specific HLA alleles, such as HLA-B57 and HLA-B27, have been observed to control HIV infection more effectively, sometimes to the point of near elimination of the virus. 2. The second reason some people can resist HIV is as a result of the difference in innate immune response. The innate immune system, the body's first line of defense against pathogens, also plays a crucial role in HIV resistance. Natural killer cells, which are part of the innate immune system, can recognize and destroy HIV-infected cells. Variations in the receptors on natural killer cells can affect their ability to detect and eliminate these infected cells, contributing to differences in HIV susceptibility. Human cells possess various proteins that can inhibit HIV replication at different stages of its life cycle. These proteins are known as host cell restriction factors. Variability in the expression and functionality of these proteins among individuals can influence susceptibility to HIV infection. A third reason why some people are resistant to HIV is repeated low-dose exposure and immune training. Some individuals, particularly those in high-exposure environments, may develop a form of resistance through repeated low-dose exposures to HIV. This phenomenon, sometimes referred to as immune training, can lead to the development of immune responses that are more effective at controlling or preventing infection. Sex workers in Kenya, for instance, have been studied for their apparent resistance to HIV despite high exposure rates, possibly due to this mechanism. Number 4. Behavioral and environmental factors. Beyond genetic and immunological factors, behavioral and environmental factors also significantly impact an individual's risk of contracting HIV. Consistent use of preventive measures such as condoms, pre-exposure prophylaxis, and maintaining a low number of sexual partners can greatly reduce the likelihood of HIV transmission. The study of naturally resistant individuals has provided invaluable insights into the mechanisms of HIV infection and has opened new avenues for developing innovative treatments and preventive strategies. As research continues, understanding the complex interplay of these factors will be crucial in the global effort to eradicate HIV and improve the lives of those affected by this persistent virus. Strategies such as gene editing to introduce the CCR5 delta 32 mutation, enhancing innate immune responses, and developing vaccines that elicit strong adaptive immune responses are all being evaluated. We will be making more update on this, and you will be notified if you subscribe and hit the notification bell.